You are a beautiful and unique snowflake. You are not a beautiful and unique snowflake. No one else is exactly like you. You're one in a billion. You realize that means there's like 8 people exactly like you? Shut up. I am a unique snowflake. That's so cheesy. There's a lot of snowflake science videos out there on YouTube, and they all mention the same idea, that no two snowflakes are alike. But where do we get that idea? The universe is a big place, it's really old, and countless planets with countless snowflakes, surely two of them have been alike. The idea that no two snowflakes are alike probably started on January 15th, 1885 in Jericho, Vermont. A 20-year-old named Wilson Bentley was sitting outside his farmhouse, freezing his Bentley's off, holding a sheet of black fabric and a turkey feather in the other hand, waiting for a snowflake to fall in just the right spot. And when it did, he put that snowflake under a microscope attached to an enormous old camera, and he held his breath. One wrong breath could ruin the whole thing. He opened the shutter and Wilson Bentley had the first photograph of a snowflake ever taken. Wilson Bentley, like, seriously loved snowflakes, in the sense that he never got married, never moved out of his mom's house, and basically just took pictures of snowflakes for like 50 years. Now, he called them masterpieces of design. Of course, we know there is no design in a snowflake, but that doesn't make them any less amazing. Every plate, every branch, every needle on a needle on a needle, all of those details are what's called emergent properties. This is complexity that's based on very simple rules. And for snowflakes, those rules go back to the basic laws of physics. In the air or in liquid, water molecules are zipping around, bouncing off of each other and everything else trillions of times per second. We have no way of knowing where they are or what direction they're facing at any moment. As we remove heat, it gets colder, and those water molecules start to slow down. Eventually, their atomic attraction, the actual hydrogen bonds between water molecules, takes over and they settle into order. It sounds complicated, but we just call that freezing. The structure of a snowflake can be found in just 6 water molecules. I know that the angle between any two hydrogens is about 105 degrees, and I know that's true for any water molecule in the entire universe. And for some of those water molecules, well, the other hydrogens behind them. Just like that, we've uncovered the 6-fold symmetry of a snowflake crystal. That crystal starts as a tiny speck of dust or pollen, which catches water vapor out of the air and eventually forms the simplest of snowflake shapes, tiny hexagons called diamond dust, and then randomness takes over. There's a very simple reason why a snowflake's arm grows out here and not here. It's just because it sticks out farther and has a higher probability that water molecules will land there. And more water molecules and more water molecules land. And then we've got an arm and another arm and another arm and on until we get the intricate and beautiful shapes that we know and love. Depending on temperature and humidity, and a lot of factors that scientists don't even understand, those simple hexagons can give rise to seemingly infinite shapes. And each snowflake will travel through different air currents and bump into different water molecules. But in 1988, researcher Nancy Knight claimed to find 2 identical snowflakes, and they do look very much alike. It's quite possible that 2 of those simple hexagons could be the same in every measurement of size and mass. But they would not be identical, and physics tells us why. We know that water molecules are made of 2 hydrogen atoms and an oxygen atom, but not every hydrogen is created equal. If we go back to the Big Bang, we find out that out of every 1,000,000 or so hydrogen atoms created, a couple hundred of them, instead of just being a proton and an electron, are holding on to a neutron. And this is the isotope of hydrogen called deuterium. In Earth's water, even in you, about 1 in 3,000 molecules will be holding on to deuterium instead of hydrogen. Out of the 1,000,000,000,000,000 molecules that make up a snowflake, a lot of them will be holding on to deuterium too. Even identical looking snowflakes are not the same. Now, you could love a snowflake just because it's pretty, but it doesn't take away from its beauty to understand that it was sculpted by chance and physics. To me, that adds to the beauty. I have to say, this whole "we are unique snowflakes" thing is pretty cheesy. It might be the most overused metaphor in the history of metaphors. So let me give you a new one. Snowflakes are symmetrical, but they're not perfect. They're ordered, but they're created in disorder. Every random branch retells their history, that singular journey that they took to get here. And most of all, they're fleeting and temporary. Even if sometimes they don't look so unique on the outside, if we look within, we can see that they're truly unique after all. Stay curious. We're not the only social animals that sit down to eat together, but we are the only ones who cook. Cultural anthropologist Claude Levi Strauss says that above all, cooking establishes the difference between animals and people.
We're gonna put a happy little arm over here. Look at that happy little snowflake. Every one of them's unique and beautiful, just like you are.